What's going on, you? I hope you're doing well. I hope you are staying safe. I hope you're being productive. I hope you are working on a better version of yourself every single day. On that note, hit the like button, smash the subscribe, turn on your bell notifications, wherever the button is, and let's jump right into it, right? As you saw in today's title, we're gonna be talking about growth. Growth, growth, growth. Growth is a very painful thing. I want you to think back to yourself about something in a certain time of your life. If you're younger, maybe you're still going through this, I don't know. I think that my videos are censored from the younger audience, which is probably the lack of views, but growth. When you were a kid, as you were growing up, you suffered from growing pains. You had growing pains in your legs and your joints and your arms and your, I don't know. You probably had growing pains everywhere. I don't remember where I had growing pains. The ones that I remember were like in my legs and in my knees or like my shins, stuff like that. It helped you develop into the person you are today. Those growing pains helped you develop into the man or woman that you are, or the man or woman that you're going to become and that you're growing into. And the same thing goes for life overall. You're going to have growing pains. Growing pains are going to come in the form of obstacles. Growing pains are going to come in the form of, if you're a creator, having blocks where maybe you're just uninspired or unmotivated, or you don't feel like getting in front of the camera. Today is an off day for me. I took the liberty of dedicating an off day from the gym, from work, from everything. I've literally just chilled out and relaxed. Haven't even left. I just sat on the sofa all day and just rested my body, rested my mind, because I needed it. My body needed it, my brain needed it. I needed it to be able to get on here. I almost even wasn't going to get on here, but I realized it was Tuesday and this should have been uploaded yesterday. But growth comes in many different forms again, and it's something that you're going to go through from now until forever. You're going to go through it with, if you have a 9-to-5 job at your job, if you have a career or you're going to school for a career, you're going to have growing pains going through that. You're going to have growing pains with your friends. You're going to have growing pains with your family. You're going to have growing pains with your spouse, with your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your husband, your wife. You're going to have growing pains no matter what. And the more that we accept them and the less that we attach to them, the easier life becomes, because the times that become growing pains and the times that we have to learn something, whether it's a decision that we made that we shouldn't have made, or something that we do that didn't work out the way we wanted it to, or a relationship that didn't go to plan, if it's not a positive, there's always something to learn. I don't look at things as failures. I don't look at things as negatives. I just look at it either as a positive or I learned, one or the other, and they're both equal, because if it's positive, there's something to learn from it and be able to replicate that and multiply it to have more positives in life. And if it is a learning curve, then there's something to learn from to then turn that into a positive down the road, right? You're going to have spiritual growing pains where you might feel lost, or you might feel like you're on the wrong path, but you know you're not, but you're just having like an off day or an off week, or it's just been an off period of time. And the best way to get through those times is just pushing through, no matter if you're having the best day or the worst day ever. You just gotta literally keep pushing forward. You have to keep trying to be the best version of yourself. You have to keep trying to figure out ways to, if you're feeling down, figure out ways to raise your vibration and to get yourself out of that funk that you're feeling. Don't let that funk take you over, because I know people that go into funks for days, weeks, months, years even, because they let that define them and they don't have the willpower to pull themselves out of it, nor do they really care enough to, because a lot of, for majority of people, everybody, whether you still do it now or you used to, I used to make excuses for everything. I used to make excuses for literally every single, like if I was having a bad day, I would just make the excuse that like, I don't need to do anything because I'm having a bad day and I'm just going to let this consume me. But then because I would make those excuses and I would allow that for myself, it would turn into 2 days, and then it would turn into 3 days and 4 days and 5 days. Like today, I gave myself a break because I I deserve it. I think that I work a lot. I spend a lot of time creating content. I spend a lot of time working on the computer. Spend a lot of time doing other forms of work, or even working out. So it was just, today was a day that I let everything rest, recover, and I'm filming content now. Once I'm done this, I'm gonna go edit it, and I'm gonna work for a few hours tonight. It doesn't mean I take the whole day off, but I take time off of certain things that I do, and the thing about me doing that is I don't find an excuse to do that. I don't use the excuse of me not feeling well to do that. I just use the reason of me just needing a break and needing to recharge. And there's a difference between an actual reason and an excuse. An excuse is kind of your scapegoat and how you justify things that you do, and a reason is something that there's like, you know what, I've gone to the gym twice a day every day for the last 5 days, my body's exhausted. That's a reason as to why my body needs a break today, and I didn't do one, I didn't do two, I didn't do any workouts today. So you have to be able to identify the differences and not just say, well, I just don't feel like working out, so you're not gonna work out. That's just an excuse because you don't feel like working out. It's not really a reason, right? Same with not wanting to create content, or same with not wanting to work on your online business, or same with this, that, the other. People, I love how Gary Vee says, work, if you have a 9-to-5, then work from 7-to-2, or work from 7-to-12 on your business at home, right? People will use, oh, I have a job, or oh, I have a family, or oh, I have this or that, the other, why they don't work on what they're supposed to be working on, why they're not doing what they're supposed to be doing. And if you're constantly making excuses for yourself as to why you're stagnant, or if you use your age as an excuse as to why you're unhealthy, or why you can't do this or why you can't do that, I don't believe in any of that shit. I know people that are 60 years old just starting businesses and just coming up. I know people that are 17 years old making millions of dollars. I know literally from one extreme to the other, from people that are in their late 60s or late 50s that take control of their health and they start working out and they lose 100 pounds or they lose 40 pounds or 50 pounds and they get in shape and they're in better shape than their kids, and vice versa. It's just there's no excuse as to why you can't do anything in life. The only excuses are the ones that you're going to create for yourself. And a lot of times people look at growing pains as an excuse to not do something, as an excuse to sit around and just let it consume them, as an excuse to not push themselves to create content, not push themselves to go to the gym and better their health, not push themselves to create that business or to keep growing their business. Even with businesses, you're going to have times where your business goes through growing pains. You could have like 4, 5, 6 months that are super successful, and then like 1 or 2 slow months. That doesn't mean that you go and you just give up on the business and you go and find something else to do. That's just part of being an entrepreneur. That's part of running your own business. That's also the beauty of it, because in that time, in that downtime, you can now spend more time figuring out how to build it 10 times better when it starts getting busy again, right? Or how to stop that dry spurt and make it busy again, whether it's through ads or through handing out flyers or going knocking on doors. Like, the only thing that really separates the winners and losers is the losers constantly make excuses and the winners just find ways to get shit done no matter what. And the effort that you put in through those growing pains, whether it's emotionally, spiritually, financially, physically, whatever the case is, the effort that you put in during those hard times is going to pay off 10 times more than any excuse that you can make. And a lot of times it's going to pay off 10 times more than the effort that you're putting in consistently over time, because those hard times are what defines us. Those hard times, emotionally, spiritually, financially, physically, those hard times are what define us and separate the winners from the losers. Because the losers, and I don't mean losers like, oh, you're a loser, I mean just people that aren't where they want to be, they just bend the fold and they let their current circumstances define the next 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months. Whereas the winners are like, you know what, like, let me, they just find a way to pull themselves out of the hard times. They find a way to raise their vibration, whether it's the music or reading or getting up and jumping on the sofa or running around naked outside, whatever the case is, they find ways to push through the hard times. And like when you were a kid, you didn't just like, oh, my legs hurt, I'm just gonna sit around for the next month or two until they stop hurting, or I'm gonna sit around for the next year until they stop hurting, or like when you were a baby and you were learning how to walk, that's a growing pain, right? That's not a physical growing pain, but that's a well, yeah, if you eat shit and you fall, it's growing pain because you hurt yourself. But I mean it in the sense that, like, when you were learning how to walk, you didn't, like, the first time you stood up, you didn't walk to the supermarket with your parents. Like, you didn't go tie your shoe, walk, dress yourself, and walk to the supermarket. You walked 1 or 2 feet, and then you walked a few more feet, and you probably fell. And then maybe you got up and you took one step, and then you fell. But it was progress. Every time that you got up, maybe you walked a little bit further, or maybe you made it to another piece of furniture in your house, or whatever the case was. You didn't, as a kid, like, you don't really. That's the difference between adults and children. I feel like adult or children, like, when they want to do something, they just do it, whether they get hurt or whether they, whatever the case is. I feel like there's less bullshit and cloudiness in a child's head, whereas an adult just, like, well, I feel like adults, and when I say an adult, I mean like anyone above the age of like 18, like realistically the legal age of an adult. They look for excuses as to why they're not doing what they should be, or why they're not where they're supposed to be, or why they're not doing this, or why they're not doing that, instead of just like fucking all the excuses and just going out and doing it, no matter what the result is, no matter if their goal that they have for a month takes them a year or 2 years or 3 years or 4 years, because at the end of the day, like, that time is gonna pass. If you're watching this, like, I can't imagine that anybody's like, oh, well, I only feel like living for another year and a half. Like, if that's your game plan, and like, you're just like gonna fucking, you're like, well, you know what, I'm gonna risk it one day and jump out of a plane and skydive without a parachute, and like, if I live, I live, if I don't, it was a good run. Like, I don't know, cool, I guess that's your thing, but I don't think that there's anybody watching this that's saying this. And I think that everybody wants to live a long and fruitful life. So like, if you're expecting to live a long and fruitful life, the time is gonna pass anyway. So whether you're sitting around and making excuses for the bullshit as to why you're not healthy, or why you're not successful, or why you don't have the income you want, no matter what age you are, or what body type you are, or what genetic background you came from your families, and blah, 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 all the other fucking bullshit you tell yourself, you have two choices. Either get up and push through the growing pains and get up and push every day like it's your last day, or just sit around and fucking become a victim of life, because no matter what you believe in, God, the universe, whatever it is, the universe, I'm going to look at it as the universe does not reward people that are victims of their life. The universe doesn't reward people that look for any excuse from their past as to why they're not doing this, or use anything that they've been through from their past or trauma that they've been through as to why they're not doing this, or why they're not doing that, or why they're not here, or why they're not there in life, or why they're however old and they're unhealthy, or this, that, the other. They just, the universe rewards the people that work, no matter how hard the times are, no matter how good the times are. And that's why you see people that they're called overnight successes, because they put the grind in when nobody's paying attention, and then all of a sudden they blow up, or their business blows up, and now they're classified an overnight success. But they just pushed through the hard times, they pushed through all the growing pains, and they never gave up on whatever they wanted to do. So I hope that this inspires you and motivates you to do the same. I hope that it inspires you and motivates you to keep pushing through the hard times, because just know that you're not the only person that's going through a hard time, and you never will be the only person, because there's billions of people on this planet, and everybody has a story, everybody has a past, everybody's gone through stuff. But just don't let your past define who you are today and who you're going to be tomorrow. On that note, I hope you enjoyed this vlog. I will see you in a few days for another vlog. I love you guys. Stay safe, stay motivated, stay hungry, bitches.